What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Cheap Tool Reviews, the channel that reviews the cheapest tools from eBay, Amazon, AliExpress, Wish, you name it, and we'll review, guys. And of course, if you're new to the channel, don't forget, hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you know when we upload new videos. And anybody watching this video, if you really like what you're seeing, don't forget, hit that like button and share this video with your friends. So of course, I want to start off, guys, with finally, we're back making videos. It's been about a month since we made videos, guys, and I was on vacation, but it wasn't a good vacation. So as you guys know, in the last video, you guys saw I injured my leg. The reason why we didn't make a following video, I actually ended up getting my wisdom teeth taken out. So I wasn't able to talk, guys. This whole month has just been, it's been all over the place. But, you know, we're coming into the new month, and hopefully we'll come in better and stronger and making videos every week, guys. So let's go ahead and get started with this tool review, guys. So this was, I've actually been wanting one of these for a while, but I never bought it because some of the big box stores, they were pretty expensive, so I never bought it. But I found this is the cheapest self-adjusting wire strippers, and I forget what the prices are like on these, you know, actually big box stores, what the cost of this is, but this was found on eBay for like $9 and some cents with taxes and everything, comes out like 10 bucks. But I mean, it's not bad if it works for 10 bucks. I guess I could look to see what the normal price of these things are. Let me check real quick. Wire strippers right here at Lowe's, 10 bucks. Oh, not 10 bucks, $21. So we'll see if this competes, you know, if this will get the job done. So we're gonna get some wires and whatnot and see if this thing actually works. Let's open this thing up. The brand is Vector Tools. No idea if that's any good. Hopefully it is, we'll find out. You can see how that works. You see when you press it. So that's gonna supposedly do it automatically. It has this adjustment knob. I'm not sure what that does. Might be how tight it grabs the wire. I don't know, we'll figure it out. But nothing much to really look at here, I guess you could say, but it has a pretty strong spring inside there because it's pretty strong. And what is this? This is for wire cutter right here. And what is this? To crimp the wire, I believe. Yeah, crimp the terminals and whatnot. I hope it works. I'm going to figure it out right now, guys. We're going to get some wire and see if this works. I hope it does because I get tired of always using the, you know, the normal type and put the wire in, the gauge, and grab it and pull it. If this does it by itself, you know, you'll be ahead of the game and cutting time, because you know, doing one by one like that takes some time. And this, if you just throw it in there, strip it, and if it works, guys, I really hope it does. But let me go outside, guys. Let me find some wire, and I'm gonna come right back in here, and we'll see if it works any good. I got some wire that we're gonna try and strip. But before we continue to stripping the wire, I want to say thank you for all the subscribers that we continued getting, even though we weren't making videos for the whole month. You know, that really shows that you guys do like what we do. And hopefully we continue to get more subscribers. When we stopped making videos, we were like at 120. We're about to hit 150. So thank you guys for all the support. I read all the comments, guys, even the mean ones. I don't care. I mean, it is what it is. That's the internet for you. So let's go ahead and continue with stripping this wire. So I got three different sets of wire. You know, this is something that like your common electrical person would use. I don't know if this exact color, but you know, it has three wires. Not really, it has two wires in the ground. And then I got this other wire that has actual strands inside of it. So we're gonna see if this actually works with this. So let's see. All right, let's see. I guess you just, I don't know if you guys can see it, but I hope you can. I guess you just put it in there and, hold on. Okay, maybe this is to adjust the strength of the jaw, because that's what seems to be the problem there. Let me tighten that up. All right, let's try that. All right, guys, let me figure this out for a second. Well, I was messing with it and I figured out what the problem is. It's this wire specifically has like this clear coating with these letters. That's what's was stopping it from stripping, because it would just slide over this plastic piece. But let's see if this works. Well, we stripped it. Maybe, oh, I can adjust it a little longer here. So let's see if that helps. So it does strip the wire, but Oh, there we go. It's not bad. So you can see here, this kind has the strands inside, but let's see if it works for this kind here. And whatever. You can see here that this is the adjustability, how much you want to strip. I think you can pull it down and pull it out. Yeah, so this would be your adjustability here. How much you want to strip. So let's strip this kind of. So it works, but it seems to have some problem. You see that? Look at that. So I guess it really works when it feels like it. Maybe that's not what the problem was. It seems to just cut the wire in any random spot, not specifically where it cuts that. Even with this adjustability, I can't seem to figure out what it does because it just spins that little bit. If anybody knows what that does, let me know in the comments, please. But let's see, let me try again. And it does have a wire cutter here, so let's see. The wire cutter part works pretty good. Yeah, see, so it's not really cutting it where it should. It ends up cutting it way longer than what you really want. So yeah, guys, you guys just saw it work right in front of the camera. And, you know, some people say read the instructions and whatnot, but there's no instructions. This is all I got. It's just this. But we'll see. Let me see. Let me try one more time, see if this actually works. So yeah, it ends up cutting the wire, but you'd have to do it double for it to actually work. I've seen other videos where the first try, it just strips it the whole way. So, I mean, I don't really know if this is any quicker way than the other ways, honestly. Like I said, it doesn't work if it has that coating. This adjustable knob, no idea what it does. It doesn't seem to move anything, actually. If anyone can figure out how this works, let me know, guys. The wire cutter itself, it works decent. It's not super sharp, but it'll do, I guess. That seems to be the only real issue with this wire stripper, I guess you can say, because you can see here, it'll cut it, but with this wire, it's not going to work. You can see there, just slips. And this one here seems to work when it feels like it. So right now it's working just fine, but I've noticed that it doesn't really work sometimes. See? No idea why. I think it has something to do with this adjustability here, but like I said, I can't seem to figure out what it does. It doesn't even tell me. It just says wire stripper automatically adjusts to any wire size, professional or DIY use, quick, clean wire stripping. Also incorporates a positive alloy steel jaws, wire cutter and terminal crimper. So I mean, you got a crimper here and a wire cutter, but for 10 bucks, I think I'd rather spend the extra 10 bucks and get something that's gonna work every time, because this is kind of a headache trying to figure out how to make this work. You know, if it's self-adjusting, it should work right out of the box. I shouldn't have to adjust this piece that does nothing. I can't seem to figure out what that part does. No idea, guys. So you can see here, it just spins. Let me try again. Oh, nope, same thing. So yeah, and then you can see too, the jaw that's supposed to hang onto the wire, look what the problem is. I can hold it with my finger. Look at it. So I don't think it's supposed to be like that. I'm pretty sure it's supposed to have pressure to bite down on the actual wire while it cuts it. But I mean, if I can just pinch it like this and stop it, I don't know what the problem is there. No idea, but we'll go ahead, guys. We're gonna finish the video off here. Kind of works, kind of doesn't. I guess it's a 50-50 shot if it's working or not. 10 bucks. I guess you can spend the extra 10 bucks, guys. Go to Home Depot or Lowe's or whatever and probably get yourself a better wire stripper. Only because if you're gonna buy this, I'm pretty sure you're gonna be, you know, doing some type of electrical work. You want it to be working every time you press it. So for that case, guys, 10 bucks. I personally wouldn't recommend this tool to anybody. Not really worth it for $10. I mean, if anybody knows what this does, I will do another test if somebody can figure out what this does, guys. So let me know in the comments what you guys think about this video, guys. Share it to any of your electrician friends. Let them know that the $10 wire stripper from eBay does not work very good. Spend the extra 10 bucks, get something better. But you guys know, guys, we're gonna be here again next week and continue making these videos. Hopefully the next video is gonna be a little bit better. We're gonna try and use a different camera, different background, guys, and let me know what you guys think in the comments of the videos and anything you guys want me to review. Some people have been saying for me to review certain things. The review is coming, guys. Just give us a little bit of time, but we're gonna get to it, guys. So again, I want to say thank you guys for all the subscribers, all the likes, and continuing support we got, guys. See you guys next week.